again at the Muslim View, and today we're here at the London Muslim Mosque with Imam Amin Al-Ali.
Yes.
Welcome to our show.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Imam, it's a pleasure for us. As you should know, the Imam is Imam Amin is, let's say, new in at the mosque, but we want to ask him who he is and all his plans and his history. So, Imam, what do you tell us about you?
Oh, first of all, thank you very much for this appointment and this show. I am Dr. Amin Al-Ali. I came to London, and it's a new life for me here in London, Canada. I was in Chicago, actually, in the U.S., and I spent there around 14 years serving the community and helping people to become better in their life and serve the community in many, many different fields. So I started this career long time ago. It's a long story. around 22 years ago, when I graduated from Al-Balqa University in Jordan, my native country. Then I went to Saudi Arabia. I got a job there as an imam too. Sometimes they asked me, how do you get this job in Saudi Arabia? While many people there, they can do the same job. I told them this is kind of resources that I had before to serve the community. So they chose me from many, many people. And I went there, I served the community in Saudi Arabia, in the east coast of Saudi Arabia. They call it the Al-Mantaqa Al-Sharqiyya, which is the east part of Saudi Arabia. It's too close to Bahrain, too close to Qatar, the two countries, small countries there. And I spent around 8 years there. And because of the hot weather, I left this country and I chose another country, which is Chicago. They told me Chicago's too cold in the winter and it's a little bit hot in the summer. That's what I felt, and this is what I found out after serving the community there 14 years. So I, alhamdulillah, I served the community and I get another contract here in London, Ontario, to come and serve the community. The community in Chicago, it's a large community, but because of we have many mosques there, it become very easy to serve the community because the job is it's between you and other mosques. We share the job. It's around 100 mosques in
wow.
Chicago.
And
yes, and our masjid, our mosque there, it's one of the mosques that we consider it as an Arab community. So we serve the community, alhamdulillah, there, and we came here in London to serve the same community. Actually, we have 75% from the community here from Arab countries and 25% from other nationalities. And alhamdulillah, we can serve them and to become better in our life, to teach them how to be a good Muslim, to serve the community at large. And the community here, around 33,000 people from Muslim community, actually, but they do not attend the main activities here in the mosque. Just in Friday prayer, maybe we had last Friday around 5,000 for two congregations, but it's not enough. We encourage everybody here in the community to come to share us our activities and to participate in our activities. This is how become a good Muslim and how to deal with others, to our neighbors, to our friends here in London, Canada.
You told us that you went from Jordan to Al-Hasa in Saudi Arabia, and then you went to Chicago, now London. But let's talk a little bit about what you found about the difference between in Saudi Arabia with Chicago, with the population, with the actual community.
You're actually in Al-Hasa, the city in east of Saudi Arabia. It's a Muslim country, as you know, and the people there, they are Muslim. They do not find any other nationalities there. But the Muslims there also, they are from different nationalities, especially when there's from Bangladesh, from Pakistan, from India, who works in Saudi Arabia. But the experience that we found, the difference between two cities or two countries, that the people in Chicago widely open, and the experience with them will be has many differences because of the situation that the country has in United States. So the people there in Saudi Arabia, they are very friendly. It doesn't mean that the people in Chicago not friendly, but because of the same resources, they will consider you as an imam from different country, yes, but they respect you, they give you your rights, and they will treat you well in the mosque. But at the same time, you will find many mosques around you in Saudi Arabia.
Absolutely.
For example, you will lead the prayer here in your mosque, and you will hear the other mosque leading the prayer next to you.
We will go for a small break, and when we come back, we continue the Muslim view.
Many things that you do not take care about it, because they have their own organizations in Saudi Arabia. They can't take care of those problems, for example, for the families of problems, because they have another organization under the umbrella of government that take care of those problems. So you don't have that stress in your job.
Yeah.
But in Chicago, you are not just an imam. We call it in Arab countries, it's an imam who lead the prayer, and that's it. And sometimes they give the community some lectures. But here in the U.S., you are the imam, you are a small court, let me say that. People will come and they will explain their problems in front of you, and you have to solve it. So you are not just a spiritual leader that you lead the prayer and that's it. You are one of those people who fix the problem, who will go out and talk to people. You will invite people to come to the mosque. Sometimes you ask them for donations. Saudi Arabia, you don't ask anybody for donation, because the government itself take care of the masajid or the mosques, so that you do not care about financial problems. Here in Chicago and in the West in general, you have to bring people to the mosques, you have to invite them, you have to encourage them to come to the mosque and participate in their activities. The other thing that the mosques in Saudi Arabia, they do not have that activities actually like what we have here in the West, and even in London or in Chicago. Here, the mosque itself is not just a mosque.
It's the
house of everybody. They consider it as a second house for many families. So they come, they have parties, they have their own function that they address it in the mosque. So they feel comfortable when they come to the mosque, because they feel it's a second house, not just a mosque. I want to come to pray and I leave. No. Here they can come and sit with the imam, sit with the community. We have parties. We have another congregation that we meet with the people in the masjid. So the differences between the mosques here in the West in general and in Saudi Arabia, it's way different.
Basically,
because of the function that they have.
Yeah.
And then the mosque here, you act like the leader. You have to lead the community.
Yeah.
And Saudi Arabia, as in different countries, in Muslim countries, they do not act like this. The mosques, they build the mosque to have a space for people to come and they pray, which is great, but not like the mosques in the West.
In the West, You're more than, there is more than a spiritual leader.
Yeah.
Here is an actual and community.
Yeah, that's
leader.
True. That's true. That's true.
Yeah.
So we find this experience, it gave me a lot of opportunity to serve the community, to see what's the community, what's going on in the community. And I did not have that experience in Saudi Arabia. I just meet people there in the mosque. When we leave the mosque, sometimes they invite me to have a dinner or lunch with them. And here in Chicago, no, you have to act as a leader, and you have to lead the community for their benefit in their life here.
In their life. Mm-hmm. Okay, Imam, now let's come into London now. Yeah. So around three weeks ago, you took the position of the Imam of the London Muslim Mosque, mm-hmm. which everybody's been extremely happy having you here.
Thank you.
And how you found the community?
First of all, the community here in this mosque, actually, in London Muslim Mosque, it's way different about the experience that I had in Chicago. As I told you, the community there, you will not find them that many people in the mosque, because we have many mosques around us. But here, it's concentrating on this mosque. We have another mosque with Sheikh Jamal Talib, in the east side, in the south side of London. So here we have many people, actually, and every day, not like Chicago, every day I have something to do with the people. In Chicago, maybe it's every 2 days or every 3 days I have something to do to deal with people, with others. But here, every single day I have something to
Lots
do.
Of people.
A lot of people. And it's become more responsibilities.
Yeah.
Here in London Muslim Mosque. About the city itself, it's if I compare it with Chicago, it's a small city.
Yeah. You know.
In Chicago, we have around more than 5 million people during the day time and 3 million people during the night time. But the people there, it's a large city. You know, if you want to go to visit someone, you will cross the city. You need maybe hour and a half to across the city. Here, maybe 15, 20, 30 minutes, you
maximum.
Will get, yes, you will find everybody around the city. I love this city because of the crowded, not that much.
Yeah.
In Chicago, if you want to spend sometimes, if you want to do something with the, let me see, the paperwork with the government or the any other apartment department in the city of Chicago, you will spend the whole day doing that. Here, maybe half hour, 1 hour, 2 hours, you will find
everything is
And this is very good. I lived around 12, 15 minutes from the mosque, and the people in the mosque, they told me it's too far from the mosque. It's 15 minutes. I told them in Chicago, if I want to go somewhere, I have to have more than
an hour
to come back to the mosque. So the city is a little bit small, but it's beautiful. I find that I love it more than Chicago, actually, even though I spent 3 weeks. But at the first time when I stop here and start dealing with the city, with the traffic, I love it. Because it will give me more convenience that you deal with the community first and you deal with the city itself.
More peace, too.
More peace and calm, you know.
Calm, yeah. Calm.
It's a calm city.
Okay, welcome back to The Muslim View. We're talking with Imam Amin Al-Ali. He is the new Imam from the London Muslim Mosque. We are really happy to have him on our show. He's been telling us his story and all his path in this world, this life as an Imam, which has been very, very interesting. How you found that the Eid here in London, being in a place so large?
You know, the community itself, the community gives the Eid the happiness that you have. In Chicago, actually, we have the same thing, but with a small amount of people. Here, it's a large city, and I'll find the Eid like the Eid in our countries, back there in Jordan and Saudi Arabia, that many people attend the Eid, many people happy, and they spend a good time during the Eid. And the other thing that I found here, that the community is more connected than other cities like Chicago or somewhere else in the U.S. Yeah. I think because the community is very large and the city is small.
Yeah.
So they appear if you walk in the street, if you drive your car, or sometimes you're walking, you will find the Muslims in the street. You will find somebody that you know them, they come to your masjid. And so I feel that the community here, it's they have many connections with others, not like other communities and
more,
other cities.
More brotherhood.
More brotherhood, yeah. Yes, let me say that.
Yeah.
Millions of Arabic and Muslims are celebrating Eid, which is held every year in the 12th month according to the Islamic calendar. The celebration of Eid in every Arabic and Muslim country is related to the occurrence of the pilgrimage, or Hajj, to Makkah in Saudi Arabia. The pilgrimage to Makkah occurs from the 8th to the 12th of the same month, when millions of pilgrims, or Hajjij, fly to the Mecca in Saudi Arabia to perform the ritual around the Kaaba inside the Al-Masjid Al-Haram.
What are you expecting from Hajj? What's coming and which message you want to give the community?
Yes, Hajj is one of the pillars in Islam, which is the last pillar that God put it as a must. You have to do it if you can one time in your life. So the Hajj is cleaning the sin. You go to Mecca, visit Mecca and do something there. And when you come back, you feel new, that God erased all your sins that you had before. So the message is for the Hajj that we brought, that to show others, to show the people, especially Muslim community, that all of them are equal. In the Hajj, you will not see a differences between people there, because they wear the same clothes, they do the same action, actually. So you will not see this is a king, or this is a prince, and this is a janitor. You will not find any differences between people there. Because when we consider it as one of the pillars of Islam, and under one God, he taught us from this that you are equal in my sight. So the best of you, the best who has a good best with the good deeds. If you have more good deeds, that means you are too close to me. So in the Hajj, it's one of the biggest action and biggest events in our religion. And if you can go, yes, you have to go, and you spend 5-10 days there, and you become anew. So the message that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the God, he wants to teach us, that you have to clear yourself every year if you can. So when you meet God, you will meet him with the perfect position, the perfect purity that you have. So here in our mosque, we encourage people, if you can go, you can go. And if you have any concerns about the Hajj, how can you do it, or what do you feel, or the experience from the people that they went there in the previous year, you just ask them and have the good experience, how do they feel. And most of people, most of them, when we ask them when they come back, that they said, I asked them in Chicago and Saudi Arabia when I was there, how do you feel after the Hajj? They said that we feel that we are new and we have to open a new page with God. So we have to clarify ourselves, and we have to purify ourselves in front of God, and we have to be a good Muslim, and we have to start our life again. So this is the message, that you will start your life and you have something new in your life. So do a good thing and be a good Muslim. And this is the message that we got from the Hajj, which is the most important message that we have from the Hajj. Another thing, that sometimes the people, they consider it as a journey, which is, yes, it's a journey, but it's a secret journey and a beloved journey, that you like to go there because of the call that Abraham, the father of the prophet, when he called people, when he asked God about the Hajj, and he told him that just say the word, ask people to come, and I will deliver the message in behalf of you. And that's what happened, that most of the prophet, they visited Mecca because of the call of Abraham, which is the father of the prophet. And our prophet, last messenger Muhammad, peace be upon him, he just respond to this call. And as a Muslim people, And the Muslims, we call we answer the call that the father of the Prophet called us 1,000 years ago. Yes.
Very interesting. Mm-hmm. So I think it's very clear what is Hajj.
Yes.
Now, Hajj here the mosque. What do you expect from the community?
We do not have any actions except the Eid, which is the second Eid that we have in our religion. After the Hajj, and we have two Eids actually. One of them after finishing Ramadan, the first day after Ramadan will be the Eid, and after the Hajj, we finish the Hajj, we have Eid, which is we consider it as a celebration after worship. When you worship God and you feel that God accepted, or you hope that God accept your good deeds, so you celebrate, which is a big celebration that we have here in the masjid, in our mosque, that we celebrate what the people did in Mecca, and we feel with them that God sent his mercies on them and on us, and we accept this mercy. So we expect from people here in the masjid to be happy that we will reach the Hajj time, and we will reach the forgiveness from God.
Yeah, so we will be posting here at the Muslim View the date where Eid or Hajj is going to happen here in London. As always, you know, there's a lot of space for all everywhere. Yeah. Okay, so once again, thank you very much, Imam. It's been a pleasure. I'm pretty sure that all our audience is really happy to
Thank you, and as
probably the voice of the community, welcome to London, and we are very sure that you're going to have a very nice
and
interesting life here.
Thank you.
If you want to ask Imam any question, please, you can send us an email, and we will sit with the Imam so the Imam we can answer to you any question, so everybody can learn more about
right.
everything.
Thank you very much. Thank you for this meeting, and I would like to thank every one of you guys that you watch us, and as he said, anytime if you want to visit us in our mosque, more than welcome. If you have any questions, you just call us, and our phone number in the website, you can just visit our website, London Muslim Mosque, and join us here for any question, any clarification you want about Islam and Muslim, more than welcome. Thank you.
Okay, so this is all for today. So we'll be back next week at the Muslim View. Thank you very much.